Welcome to our faith community of Sacred Heart on the 30th Sunday in Ordinary Time. My name is Catherine Mayhem. Today we are given as an example, not the righteous and self-justified Pharisee, but a humble tax collector who acknowledged himself as a sinner and so went home, as Jesus says, truly justified. In our lowliness, let us trust that our prayer for mercy pierces the clouds of heaven, and that justice and salvation will descend on us in our humble Lord Jesus, who feeds us his body and blood. The scripture readings are in the hymnal under number 1181, and you can find the hymn numbers and sung mass parts on the hymn board. If you have a cell phone, we please ask that you silence it at this time. And we are happy to have all ages joining the celebration of Holy Mass. If your child gets restless, please know that the entry vestibule of the church also serves as a calming room, and hospitality ministers will provide you folding chairs. We have been asked at this Mass to pray for the eternal peace of Antonio Calpo, and we invite you to stand and remain standing as we greet those around you. Please join us in the opening hymn, number 839, as we gather at your table.
Lord Jesus, you hear the prayer of those who are humble. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Thank you.
from the second letter of St. Paul to Timothy. Beloved, I am already being poured out like a libation, and the time of my departure is at hand. I have competed well. I have finished the race. I have kept the faith. From now on, the crown of righteousness awaits me, which the Lord, the just judge, will award me on that day, and not only to me, but to all who have longed for his appearance. At my first defense, no one appeared on my behalf, but everyone deserted me. May it not be held against them. But the Lord stood by me and gave me strength, so that through me the proclamation might be completed, and all the Gentiles might hear it. And I was rescued from the lion's mouth. The Lord will rescue me from every evil threat, and will bring me safe to his heavenly kingdom. To him be glory forever and ever. Amen. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
So I invite you to do a quick effort
to update it just quickly. So it would be something like that. Jesus addressed this parable to those who were convinced of their own rightness and despised everyone else. There were two people. One was a Catholic, belonged to this parish, was in the group of the Rosary, fast twice a week. For many years gave a huge and amazing service on the council of the parish. Is in the San Vicente Paul also helping. Is a model to all of us, maybe in this community. And he prayed. And the other worked for Planned Parenthood, for example, this company. And he prayed also. One was listened, the other wasn't listened. What happened? Because normally we, the Pharisees, we think that they were bad people, but they were the best of the best, and they were the ones who took most seriously their faith in their time. No? So what is the problem that Jesus wants to point here? What makes a prayer to be listened or not listened? The answer, we got it here written, I think. When the Pharisee, in this case, came to pray, he said, he spoke this prayer to himself, to his nail, I think this is called, not a nail, el ombligo. Prayed to himself. He did all these good things, but he was not speaking to God. He was speaking to himself. I'm doing all this effort, oh God, you know, so I'm doing this. I'm not like the others, so I'm relaxed because I know that when I meet you on heaven, I will merit. I will merit it. And also, you are happy with me because also I don't need your salvation. I want it in some way. So, watch to your name and watch the others in a second place. And it comes the other that probably is not a good example, for sure. Or this tax collector, we can know. But probably had a life that it was far away from that, what God would want. But what was his attitude? God, I need it for your mercy. I did this. I'm not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say a word and my soul shall be healed. This is a sentence that we will say before the communion, and this is a sentence that a pagan pronounced. So, to sum up, to make it short and to go to straight to the point, if last Sunday God was saying to us, pray with insistence, today he tell us, this prayer is not in whatever way. These prayers have important requirements. First of all, you pray to God, not to your name, and you are not worthy. Recognize yourself needed from the mercy of God, and not watch the others from a superior side. And with that ingredients, your God that is in the heaven, that knows your heart, that knows you, for sure will welcome it. Otherwise, it will be real what he pronounced, that the prostitutes and the publicans will be before of you on the heaven.
response to our intercessions is, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For leaders everywhere, that they may take care of the orphan and the lowly, protecting their people and working for the good of all, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who suffer from terminal illness and those who struggle with depression and grief, that they may be comforted as they continue to keep the faith and recall that the Lord is close to the brokenhearted, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those on our parish prayer lines, and for others who have asked for or need our prayers, and for our men and women serving in the military, especially those deployed overseas, for their safety and protection, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For these prayers, and for all the intentions that we hold in the silence of our hearts, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
So we present all of this to Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Almighty and Eternal God. For just as through your beloved Son you created the human race, you also through him with great goodness you formed him and human. And so it is right that all your creatures serve you, all the redeemed praise you, and all your saints with one heart bless you. Therefore, we do extol you with all the angels as in joyful celebration we acclaim.
Thank you.
The penny harvest continues this weekend. Drop off your pennies and any other form of currency you would like to donate in this container in the vestibule. Proceeds will go to the St. Vincent de Paul Society.
Let's see, people, listen over.